afternoon, fellow students and staff. It's Wednesday, it's the work in progress period, so you know what time it is. This is the WIP Show. In the past, we've had Mrs. Hickey, the head of the staff members, on the show, but today's about the students. I'm very pleased to welcome the head of the Student Council, the president of the United Classrooms of JLS, Owen Longstreth. Mr. President, sir.
Hello. Right, I gotta put my seatbelt on.
Yep, safety first, Mr. President, sir.
You don't have to call me sir, that's a bit unnecessary, but if you want to, that's
if you wish, Mr. President,
cool.
Sir.
All right, then.
So, Mr. President, sir, your seat's comfortable, you're all good?
Yeah,
it's
fine.
You can change it if you want to.
It's fine.
Anything you need?
It's
water, you need anything?
No.
All right. Before we start, this is a bit unprofessional, but
right.
Can I get a selfie?
Sure.
Okay. Let's begin.
Alright.
So, on the WIP Show, we've never failed to get a test in, so we're not gonna fail this time. This test is about your presidency and... Ooh. You ready, Mr. President, sir?
Yes.
Alright, let's go. Tell me how to say president in four different languages.
I don't really speak any other languages. I do know the word for leader in German, which is Führer. But unfortunately, I don't know how to say president in any other languages. I probably once did, although I've forgotten.
Okay. Well, you talked about German, actually. The way to say president in German is actually Präsident. It's very similar. And you can kind of cheat. French is Président, and Serbian is Predsednik. So... really similar. And then, obviously, English.
Yeah.
So. How do you say president in Russian?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I don't really know. If I had to guess, it's probably not borrowed from English. It's probably, Russian, or it's from some other language from Eastern Europe, like Croatian or Serbian or something. Or
so,
not Serbian.
President.
Oh, alright.
Alright. Now we move to the interesting questions. And, since you're the president, I'm pretty sure that you know all about our school.
Yes.
Pretty much everything, right? So how many students are in jazz band who have a birthday in October?
Ooh, that's tricky.
And who are boys? So boys in jazz band whose birthday are in October.
I don't know, so
Mr.
I'm just gonna make a random guess and just say, five. It seems like a good number.
I don't know either, so... And how many history teachers run clubs at JLS?
I think it's three, from my knowledge of all the clubs. I think I know them pretty well.
Oh, well, I don't know either, so we'll go with three. And those were a bit random, so we're going to move to some questions more about the topic of our show today, your presidency.
All right.
So tell us about your past experience in the Student Council.
I'd say that I don't really have very much experience, in past student council. I was a class rep in third grade. I did enjoy that. I feel like, back then it was basically exclusively run by the teachers, so I feel like I wasn't really, like, doing very much.
But is that kind of what, like, sparked your interest in student council?
Like- oh no. It was mainly, I just really like public speaking, and, we didn't really get to do that very much in seventh grade. And I just really wanted to, like, give a really big speech. And so then I decided, like, hey, I should, like, run for student council position because that's easy.
And you ran for president and you became president because
my thinking was
to do a speech?
Yeah, my thinking was basically just go big or go home. You know, I'm going to give the speech. I should make it, like, really awesome. Maybe I can, like, become student council and make the school a better place.
Wow, really nice.
Thank you.
Yeah. And what's your job now that you're a president? What's your job, Mr. President, sir?
So, I'm kind of like the leader of student council. I represent the entire student body. And I basically just, like, run the show. Like, I'm the one in charge of, like, meetings who make sure that everything's running smoothly and people aren't, like, screaming and yelling and all that kind of stuff.
So you kind of manage what's going on. And what about in terms of, like, the actual job of the student council, which is to plan these events and do these things? How do you influence that?
I pretty much have, like, a central voice in all of this. I'm kind of the one who really, like, coordinates between, like, all the classes and, like, the executives, like, the secretary and the treasurer about, like, funding and, like, the way everything, like, works and, like, whether we can actually, like, pull various things off.
So you kind of coordinate these things?
Yes, I do.
Everybody lies past sometimes, you know. And God forgive you when we feel no. Just make a deep breath and let it go. I know I'm really down in the inferno. If you're feeling you're sinking, I will jump right over it to cold, cold water for you. And all the time may take us into different places, I will still be here with you. I know, I won't let go. I'll be your lifeline tonight. I won't let go. I'll be your lifeline tonight.
How do you think I did?
You did pretty good. I don't really know the lyrics so well, so I was kind of mumbling it, but you were like, on fire.
It's Pavan, Justin Bieber, does this thing to me.
Yeah, like you're a Canadian.
Yeah, I know, I can't get out, wait, is it? Ugh, sorry, just the Justin Bieber taking over. Well, thank you for joining me, Mr. President, sir. It was an honor to have you on the show.
Yeah.
And now it's time for you to get out of my car.
Sure.